Section 8.
Utilizing continuous integration.
In this section, you will use Jenkins CI to run Selenium WebDriver test suites and learn of important considerations that will prove vital for providing continuous integration and fusing test automation with the development and deployment pipeline. Developing a framework to simplify CI integration. In this video, we will discuss what you need to do to integrate your tests in the CI pipeline. First of all, you need to understand that your tests are a cog in the pipeline and eventually in the project too. They are meant to be run frequently and on different, sometimes disposable environments. I'm saying this because sometimes you may become too attached to your tests and overinflate their role in a project. The reality is that they are a way to ensure quality of the product, which is why you are working on the project in the first place. Other than having a reality check, this mindset helps you understand what are the inputs and outputs of your test automation solution. So, how do you specify these inputs? There are quite a few ways, but only a few are reasonable. First things first, when test suite execution is invoked, you have to have environment files ready. They would contain all the information relevant to the environment under a test that is required by your testing solution. This includes, but is not limited to, product URLs, database connection strings, default credentials, message queue connection strings, etc. Now that you have the bulk of values in a convenient place, you must select the correct properties file. You can specify environment variables while calling the Maven test goal. This will work, and your solution will be able to retrieve these values. Be aware that regardless of its simplicity, this solution doesn't scale well. You don't want to be passing more than 3 variables when calling a test goal. The more civilized way, in my opinion, is Maven profiles. In a nutshell, there are collections of your project variables with particular values. One of these values will be the environment. Profiles can be combined. This allows you to separate the roles for different profiles. Say you want to be able to run tests locally on your machine and through a grid. You can easily specify separate profiles for both modes and choose whatever you need at the moment. You can store environment-specific values in profiles too. But, in my opinion, this is inconvenient since Maven's Project Object Model, or POM file, is meant for more technical content and your environment-specific values are business and not technical. Another important point to consider is that one of your environments can be a disposable Dockerized environment. This makes all the sense assuming your tests can actually be used to verify pull requests and would be run in isolated disposable environments due to sheer frequency of pull requests. Considering the containerized scenario, you should have Selenium Grid setup scripted as well. Selenium Grid setup and teardown should be separated from your testing solution and be called regardless of the results. This ensures you're not creating future bottlenecks. These notions are essential to account for when developing a framework that is to be used by other parties. Be a team player.